History repeats itself, they say. It's been a year now since the last time I was here, since I walked these streets and climbed these mountains. Back then, I was in the midst of filming a short film about climate change here in southern Greenland. Flying over the Great Island this time, it struck me how visible climate change is up here in the far north. As the plane approached the landing strip, it was clear that this year the Greenland ice sheet began its melting season a whole month before it usually does. Deceitfully blue lagoons of meltwater spread out across the expansive white blanket of ice are proof that the ice is not doing well. On one single day in June, the ice sheet lost 1 billion tons of ice, experts say. 1 billion tons of white, heat-reflecting ice that just melted in a day. Summer in southern Greenland is wonderfully colorful, with hues of blue, yellow, and red on every street corner of every small village. Which is a good thing for locals as well as tourists who just want to snap a beautiful photo, oblivious to the rapidly changing environment. I have always believed that making film with Greenland as a backdrop is an easy task. The sheer beauty of the vistas make for compelling images, the remoteness of the locations feel exotic, and the icebergs as crystals in the water makes everything feel otherworldly. I've always considered myself lucky to be able to film here and to call this place my home. Throughout history, several waves of people have tried to survive on the world's largest island. All but the most well-adapted were unsuccessful. But as a people, the Inuit have learned to live in the cold, harsh conditions where no one else could. Today, history is repeating itself. Now it's the Inuit that suffer climate change in the Arctic. Their traditional way of living is under great stress due to the general rise and frequent spikes in temperature, like during the spring, where temperatures of 16 degrees above normal were recorded in northern Greenland. As the sea ice becomes thinner year after year, proud hunters and fishermen cannot provide for themselves. And in many places, the fishing industry, the foundation of modern Greenland, has all but collapsed. What will happen to them, to their way of living? History will repeat itself. Today, changes are visible here. Tomorrow, they'll be visible somewhere else, maybe where you live. What will happen to you, to us, to our planet, to our collective home?